Day one.
Go over there. Go in that one. Get in that one. Keep it going for that man. Come on, guys.
How's it going? Good.
They're not excited at all.
Yeah, what is this? Is anybody a first timer? Very cool. Welcome. Welcome and thanks for all the support. I brought a friend.
Wait. Like a friend with benefits or like?
There may be some benefits.
Would you like to bring your friend out?
I would love to. But there's no seat.
Well, I'll get one. Why don't we move this down a little bit?
Okay.
I'm gonna move this to
y'all don't mind if I bring a friend on stage, right?
Move that. I'm gonna move this. I'm just gonna move that back. Squeeze that over. Just squeeze that over toward that way. There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. And then can you bring me a chair?
Squeeze.
Or I'll just sit on the ground. I don't mind. What friend would you like to bring out here, Jerry?
Okay. Well, I thought there might be no one better to help celebrate and culminate our 2016 Comic-Con experience, since this is the last thing I'll be doing. This buddy of mine, his name is Jensen Ackles.
Jensen? Oh. He needs a mic. We need a microphone. Here, take mine for now.
I have been waiting in line for so long.
Thank you very much.
Here, trade me.
Do you guys mind?
Take that. Keep that. Boom.
Or not.
Or yes.
Or no.
Or yes.
Do you guys mind if I join him? All right.
Well, thanks, guys. Welcome, Ackles.
Hey, Nerd HQ.
Hey, where do I get a cool hat like that, dude?
Yeah.
You do?
You better have brought enough to share. Yeah, where do we get those hats?
Check you out. That's so generous. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Besties. That's awesome.
Should we...
I'll force him to give it to me.
Jensen, should we jump into...
Well, here's the thing.
What?
I have a friend. And I hope it's okay. And then I know this is...
He's just hijacking your panel right now.
Well, I think it really does us all a favor. And otherwise it would be a disservice, really, not to have my friend come and join us on the stage.
What is your friend's name?
William Shatner.
Everybody's looking.
Did you all actually believe that?
I'm
Bill?
Kidding. He doesn't know. I would like to bring a fellow castmate named Misha Collins.
Hi.
You're the
best. I am so shocked.
Misha, welcome.
Thank you very much. Is it weird, you guys? I feel weird saying this. I actually don't have a friend to bring out, but there is somebody who's been following me around.
And take care of that. We have security.
His name is Mark Sheppard. Can we trade seats? I'm scared.
You said you were going to the bathroom.
Get up there.
You said you were going to the bathroom. To the loo.
They tell me nothing.
I hope y'all don't mind.
I am so shocked.
He's the only one who didn't know. We didn't tell Zach.
Zach's like, okay, guys, how do you want to do this?
You've got questions? We have maybe answers. Yes, down right there, right in the front. Hi. Mark.
Stand up. I was at the first NerdHQ in 2011.
Because you're awesome, thank
you. Unfortunately, not at your panel, but at
back when they pronounced it H.
She's a nerd. HQ.
HQ. Yeah.
Is that not a thing?
No. Well, it's a thing in your country.
We also
yes,
don't say they don't say Z here either.
No. But I love Z, I love good H, and thank you for supporting us for so long.
I have a question about that. For those of you that were there, mainly Jared and
Zach. Only Jared.
Jared and Zach.
These fuckers didn't care at that point.
It was still a H. It wasn't even capitalized yet.
Yeah, Zach's like, hey, so it's this little thing, and it's a NerdHQ, we got a little panel, Jared's gonna do it. I'm like, okay. Yeah.
For anyone that wasn't there,
I didn't even know you at that point.
You could walk into a shop front and buy a paper ticket on the day. Like, it was anyway, the point is...
We've tried to improve.
Yeah, point is...
Wait a second, you said I was sold out.
Not for you.
No, he said you sold out, and I didn't...
Makes more sense.
I'm sure you do. I'm sorry. If you've watched any of these panels online, you realize I can't control this.
The question is about...
You do know we have never answered a question entire 12 years of this show.
Oh, this is the worst. Okay, the question is actually...
Sorry, moving on.
Stop. Stop. Yes, you just got the bird.
She just gave the one finger victory salute.
Yes, I'm with you. I'm right here. Look at me. Don't look at that. Look at me.
This lifeline is going to do nothing for you.
About
yes.
The Nerd HQ experience.
Look at the face. Look into the eyes, not around the eyes, but into
what is your question?
Turn their mics off.
You're feeling sleepy.
You shut your mouths. What do you want to know?
Does anybody else have a question?
I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Hold on, wait. I mean, if she does, you brought it on yourself. I don't. Hold on, just give me. What is your question, honey?
What?
Yeah, no, let her speak.
Excuse me. What? Are you Australian?
Yes.
That explains everything.
We don't take questions from Australians. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I thought you were British, sorry.
Why are you telling him? We're not going to answer his bloody questions.
He doesn't know the answer.
Fantastic. I got the question. Fuck you guys. What about... The question was... Thank you very much.
That's not a question.
That's actually...
What about the NerdHQ experience has changed or stayed the same since from year one to now?
So what was your question?
Can you rephrase the question for us?
So Jared, for you then, you've been here from day one.
Yeah.
You're here day six. It's not really a day.
Day six? What's this, 24?
What do you feel like has remained the same, and what do you feel has changed?
I feel like...
For good or worse? Good or bad?
Good or badder?
Good or badder?
I feel like what has changed is the air conditioning works a lot better.
We're still working on it a little bit. Yeah. It's a little better.
Petco part
is boiling. Cleaner?
I seem to remember when when we did ours back in the day. I think like during the panel, like 15 fans.
Yeah, these little fuckers right here. Yeah, and you picked one up and started Fabioing with it. It was amazing.
I did.
He does that most days.
But usually with my own. The fans are so incredible. I think the message has kind of stayed the same. For me, it feels.
Yeah, that's what you mean, right?
Yes. Yeah. I'm saying they still work. I think it's grown. I mean, you know how much it's grown more than I do because you've been here so much. But
well, I mean, the square footage, I think, is it's a little bit bigger. But even like Jolton, anybody here was at the first year? Fuck yeah, you guys rock.
Was it under the bleachers? Was it under the thing in the ballpark?
No, that was a third Petco year. Was year three and four. So we were at Jolton Joe's year number one. Show of hands, year number one. Show of hands, yeah. Show of hands, year number two. Show of hands, year number three. Show of hands, year number four. I like that the hands keep getting bigger, but the voices are going. Did the event just suck that year? And then when I got it to five, and now six. But that would be all hands, clearly, right? So the square footage has gotten a little bit bigger, but I appreciate that you said the message is the same, because we don't want it to change. The whole point is we want you guys, we want to give a place for you guys and us to hang out, you know, safely and not, well, it's always going to be awkward. Who are we kidding? But you guys care so much, and we so appreciate that you care about what we do. We're a bunch of fucking knucklehead actors, you know, like we're the first to die in a zombie apocalypse. Like, what's going to happen? Actually, I'll be the last. No, you'll live the longest because you're already. Never mind. That's not the point. The point is, because he doesn't age. See, he doesn't. Anyway, point is, you guys are the lifeblood. The fans of our shows and our movies and TV shows and whatever the hell we do, you are the lifeblood of what we do. And all we wanted to do with the year one of Nerd HQ was create a place to give you guys a cool place to hang out and play games and ask us questions and take some photos if you can, and, you know, and have some kick-ass dance parties and shit like that, and hopefully keep it all cool and chill and safe. So if that's the same message, then I would agree. I think that's the same message, and I hope you guys think that's the same message. But the AC is a little bit better.
Was that your question?
It was my question.
Oh, good. Okay.
I'm about to get on a flight as soon as this finishes. So.
Oh.
Yeah,
my
to Australia?
Yeah, to Australia.
Where are you going?
Sydney, where I live.
It's where my wife is from, Sydney. It's a Sydney girl.
I'm glad this didn't end up in fisticuffs. That was really close.
That
next question,
gone,
please. Right,
quickly.
Right there. Yes, you holding your phone up in the air. Yes. BB-8.
All right. Hi, y'all. So my question.
That'd be a question for you if he said y'all.
It probably is. So with the announcement of the Vampire Diaries ending, are y'all gonna push for that little plug in the series?
What, to help it end?
I mean, look, there. It might be a little conflict in scheduling, seeing as how we film like thousands of miles away from each other. I just say at the end, we'll loan him an Impala and just have the Impala drive into town as the last thing you see. That's all you need. That's really all you need.
Yeah. Easter eggs. Yes.
And then the screen cuts to black and you just hear screams. And that's it.
Yes. Yeah. It cuts to black and you hear me say, Sam, can we use the grenade launcher?
You guys have thought this through, haven't you?
Yes, you right there, darling.
I'm really tall, sorry.
I know the feeling.
He doesn't.
Sorry, Mark.
What do you mean, sorry, Mark?
Yeah, it's...
Do you know what they did to me last week? We took a picture, right? There's a four shot of us, right?
Should we show them? Let's just show them what
we did. It's the worst picture ever, right? This is what they do to me.
We put him next to me.
That was it. I was like this. And we get ready for the photograph.
One, two, three.
I'm 5'4" in the photograph. I'm the only one who didn't spot it, of course. Until I get photo.
And then he sees,
approval.
He's like, wait a second. Wait, are y'all on your tiptoes? And we're like... And by the way, we didn't even discuss it before it happened.
No, they just did it automatically. Zink. That's my life. My wife is 6 feet tall, so I feel
the pain. I am too.
Yeah, it's a beautiful thing. Tall girls are special.
And tall boys?
Not so much.
Tall girls are special.
And your question is?
For Misha.
Okay, I gotta remember my question. Day one, you had a resume before Supernatural. 12 years later, is there any special skills you could say you've added since then?
Is breaking wind a special skill?
Besides farting.
There's certainly some I need to scratch off.
Really?
You know, you can, it's with like Kinko's and FedEx or whatever. You could just devour your old resume and come up with a whole new one. I mean, just in all the days of your lives, you could just do it.
I mean, that's true, and I'll wait till, you know, Friday, probably the 13th, and then...
Burn!
And I'll just get it all done and just go vacation in a Christmas cottage somewhere.
It'll take a New York minute.
Yeah. He's throwing himself under the bus. He's like, wait, I gotta throw myself under this.
I gotta.
Yeah, just maybe somewhere nice, somewhere near Stonehenge, possibly.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I heard the apocalypse was there, man. I don't wanna...
Sorry, who?
I think... I think we've all... I think the special skill I've really perfected is throwing my fellow actors under the bus. And ruining my fellow actors' takes as much as possible. That'd be him. And breaking noses with a whipped cream pie, which was a lot of fun. So,
yeah.
There are a few. In all honesty, I think that the habits I've learned probably, I'll probably never work again.
You know that the American government.
Probably not fly.
Do you know that the American government actually hired Jared to break into iPhones?
That's right. The FBI is trying to get Apple, and they're like, we can't get in, we can't get in.
Call Padalecki.
He steals your phone, and while he looks like, oh, yeah, I love this picture, he's tweeting, I hate my fans, I pick my nose.
I think my booger is a couple of special skills that I'd put on that apparently not a lot. Hitting a mark, remembering my lines. Those are apparently special skills in our industry these days.
I would certainly fucking hope so.
I've never used
them. Yeah.
I've never used those. Who needs lines?
Mark's still trying to learn. Next question. Thank you.
Oh, so many hands.
Oh, you know what? You got a friend pointing at you. I always like that. You go.
Is it a lightsaber? What do you got? What are you going to hit her with?
Oh, Jesus.
A fan.
Hi, guys. So hi. This year's going to be my fourth Gishwez.
Yes.
My
can
team.
Can I ask a question real quick? Is that the appropriate pronunciation? Gishwez?
That's how Gishwez. I pronounce it.
Just checking. Tomato, tomato. Continue.
My team. No one knows. It's a mystery. So my team, we've been runners up for the last 3 years. So we're really looking forward to this.
Loser.
What's your team?
We're the Swash Bunnies.
Swash bunnies?
Yes, we're pirate rabbits. So we're like swashbuckling.
If I had a nickel for every pirate rabbit.
And your question is, huh?
I was wondering, Misha, how are you looking forward to this year's Gishwez? And for Jensen and Jared, how terrified are you for it coming up?
And Mark. Mark is not terrified. He's already been through the ringer. We were at a convention recently. One of the items in the hunt was to make a portrait of Mark Sheppard's face from pet hair.
It was the most revolting
and someone
thing
brought
I have
one,
ever seen.
Brought one to a convention recently, and Mark was like, Misha. I'm sorry.
Misha.
And from a distance of 20 feet away, it looked like a strikingly good...
Yes.
I mean, it was a really great painting.
It had more hair than me.
Mark's face. But then as you get closer and the sort of pixels, as it were, resolved, you see that, like, this was some dandruffy animal that had, like, maybe been sacrificed. I don't know, but it was so disgusting seeing it up close.
Some of the stuff really makes me lose my appetite.
Yeah, you know, one year there was an item in the hunt that was cover yourself completely in pet hair. And I was like, nobody's going to be able to do that. And I didn't think, of course, about pet grooming facilities where they have vast stores of pet hair. So people made these complete and elaborate suits where they would, like, take something from a Dalmatian, put it here and something. And so it looked like there were patterns and textures and... It was awesome. But anyway, this is Zach's first year in the hunt. And
he is super excited about it.
And I am immediately regretting it. Literally, these guys are looking at me going, this is why we don't do it. Human level pet hair. Yes, you sir, right here. I'm famous in Israel.
No.
I hope you are.
Hey, guys, I just want to see you've been doing it for 11 years, your CW smolders.
Wasn't she on How I Met Your Mother? I know, it's Kobe Smulders.
We have it. It's called the labored inhale. One, two, three.
Can I just briefly sidebar there? That reminds me of the first year that I went to the upfronts with you guys. And you guys had, at that point, absolutely perfected the CW Smolder.
Yeah.
So we got up, can we just do one more demonstration? We got up to the, like, red carpet to do the shots, and it was like this.
And you didn't know until the next day when you see all the shit online, you're like, what was I doing? Why did no one tell me?
What is that? It's not true. They know.
Just the super earnest, like, I'm on a show with these guys and I'm happy.
There's also like the decidedly, like, pointedly casual glance to the back of your shoe where you're like, as if like, did I step on something?
Yeah, or did somebody ask me a question? No?
I still don't think it's fair that that's called the smolder, but that's just me. Thank you.
Burn.
Let's go. Burn indeed. Let's go. I want to get somebody back there. closest to you, Brian, right there. That right there. Yep.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
You just materialized from my perspective. I didn't see you at all. You just gradually rose up. It was like the whack-a-mole. You just all of a sudden... There was nothing, and then there was you.
Like a pirate bunny.
You missed it. She raised like this. Thanks. And she's gonna sit like that.
Like a phoenix from the ashes.
Great posture.
My lord.
Don't pay any attention to that. What is your question?
I got to ask the Stephen Amell panel this question, and...
It's the wrong panel. We're on Supernatural. I mean, I like him, but it's not the same panel.
Yeah. What's your current favorite song to sing at the top of your lungs in the car?
Ooh. Definitely.
So
this
is actually true, and I don't know how this came to pass, but my children, well, actually, they sing. There's two songs for some reason that they have glommed onto. One is a song by this guy named Stu, and it goes, there's a naked Dutch painter in the kitchen that does not want to fuck you. And
Parenting 101.
And the other, so and that was whatever.
We've really come a long way since the Teletubbies and shit. Yeah. That I don't... What is happening?
I actually got a video of my daughter with like the pacifier in her mouth in her like baby cartoon going, naked Dutch painter in the kitchen does not wanna fuck you.
Does he go on to explain what problem the Dutch painter has with you?
Like, why not? What's wrong with me? And then the other one, weirdly, is Carry On My Wayward Son that they heard at a friend's house, because I don't like go around playing that in the car. But they, like, they're nuts about Carry On My Wayward Son. True story.
Once again, I'm going to blame my kids, though it's a good band, a good song. Fits in the Tantrums, Hand Clap. Yeah, yeah. Which is troublesome while driving your 2-year-old and 4-year-old.
Parenting 101.
Jensen.
Brittany, you better work, bitch.
Max, who's backstage right now with his buddy, will tell you that the first song he used to sing at the top of his lungs was Sexy Motherfucker by Prince.
Parenting 101. Right there on the aisle, right there. One back, yeah. But then I'll come to you next. How's that sound? Fair deal.
Sorry, guys. I lost my voice on day two. So.
How dare you?
I know.
Are you Australian?
No.
Sound Australian now.
She's Southern.
I'm very Southern, yes. I'm from
Same thing. It's Australia's down there in the Southern Hemisphere.
Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Talk to me.
We'll work it out.
Sorry, that reminded me of a story. So we're shooting an episode of Supernatural. I think it might have been season four or five. And there's this table. We're in an operating room. There's a heart on the table, I remember. And Jordan and Jensen are standing on one side of the table, and I approach, and I have my dialogue, and I come up to the table, and I'm saying my dialogue, and Jared has a broomstick in his hand under the table, and he finds my crotch.
Which is hard to find, by the way.
Parenting 101.
Full disclosure. Just disclosure, man.
If we don't have Parenting 101 trending at the end of this, I don't know. We failed.
So every take, he's like doing that, and then the first AD takes the broom away from him, and then on subsequent takes, he's just like making faces at me when I come up. One of my special skills on my resume is not laughing when someone does something while I'm on camera. So I was messing up every take. The director was getting angry because he didn't see what Jared was doing, and Jensen stepped up and he said, "Hey, man, don't even look at him. Just look at me. Just look at me." I was like, thank you for that lifeline. Like one person, he did that. And so we did the next take, and I come up and I look at Jensen and he goes.
Fish in a barrel.
Stuff writes itself.
So look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me.
I'll try. Okay.
Look at me.
You just tasted my tears.
Yeah. Tasted nice.
I didn't actually have a question for
Jared. Wait a minute.
Hey. You didn't let me finish. I didn't actually have a question for Jared, but now that Misha's here, I do have a question for you. But Jared, what I wanted to say, hey, hold on.
I like your attitude.
Is that a Southern thing?
Keep going, keep.
Okay, but Jared, what
that
I
That reminds
to
me
say,
of another story.
Stop, yes.
Oh, we got time.
Stop
for
it. Stop
Maybe
it.
Maybe I don't want to say this after all.
No. You've already been standing. Please, please.
Okay, Jared, what I want to say is I want to say thank you personally from me because I have lived for all of my adult life with bipolar disorder and depression with a little bit of anxiety on the side. And I have always felt alone. And with you really reaching out about mental disorder, it has really made me feel more like I know that there are more people in the world who feel the way I do. And it has really changed my life. And I want to just say that I appreciate everything you've done.
Look at me, look at me. Don't give me crazy ideas.
Too late.
Okay, now my really quick question, Misha.
Which reminds me of a story.
I'm gonna milk this for all I can. Okay, Misha, you have to play so straight all the time, but I never see you outside. Straight face, people, come on, straight face.
Don't, but nobody's getting excited.
You should know better than to.
Have you read my shirt? Okay, you know what kind of a fan I am if you've read my shirt, all right?
Keep going. So he has to play straight all the time.
Okay, you have to play straight-faced all the time, but I never see you outside of your work without a smile on your face. How hard is it for you to be so straight-faced and just never crack a smile when I know they're just fucking around all the time with you?
What you're saying is how difficult is it to try and force a smile when you're not on camera to pretend like you're enjoying.
Pretend that I'm happy.
That's good.
No. It's very easy for me to do a performance as Castiel without cracking a smile. Usually I can get that done in 25 or 30 takes. there are troves of footage lying on some editor's floor of me laughing maniacally at times when I'm supposed to be straight faced. So you're seeing a tiny fraction of the footage captured. That's the secret.
And most of it's just being reused from season 4 and 5. You'll notice backgrounds change and like the lines are all spliced together. So
I promised this girl that I go to her right after. Yeah. Is that?
Thank you.
Oh, there you go.
Hi. I just moved to San Diego and this is my first year at NerdHQ. So thank you very much for coming back. I really appreciate it. But something I've been really curious about, so I think that Supernatural might be the number one consumer of brown trench coats. So, you know, this is for everybody, a guesstimation. How many trench coats do you go through in a season or since, you know, Cass has joined?
That's a good question.
I actually don't, I have no idea what the answer is to that, but it's definitely, it's probably getting close to 50, I'd say, that we've gone through at this point. They ran out of trench coats. So these were all from
the world.
The world. There was one, they bought one and they're like, oh, we'll need a few of these. So they got like 3 of them to start with. And then they're like, oh, this guy's sticking around. All right, we'll get 5. And then they went back to the chain department store that they bought them from. They bought all of the rest that they had. And then they had to start making them from scratch. Because every time you get shot or stabbed or.
Now he goes to conventions and steals them off people.
Yes, right over there.
So I'm here just to pass a quick message. Jared, for your birthday game, we collected money and we donated it.
Yeah.
This year it was $2,294 to Operation Smile. And really quick, as Jensen asked us, we want to encourage you to always keep playing.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Let's give her another round of applause. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Right in the back, the red walk. Yeah, it's right there.
So cool. I'm going to try to...
Go team, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah, hell yeah. That's awesome.
Wait, is that backpack full of money? Is there some for me in there?
Money?
No, not money.
No?
I hope you like the chest set,
too. The check? Yeah, I'll take the chest check. MasterCard, Visa.
It's in
I'll single. Explain it to him later, don't worry.
Okay, very good.
And yes, and what is your question?
So first of all, I want to thank you, Jared, as well, with bringing all of your friends and your friends and your friend.
And the guy that just showed up?
One guy followed my other friend's friend.
I mean, thank you for powering through with everything. I mean, I haven't been to Comic-Con for like 10 years because of tickets. I've lived in San Diego my entire life.
Oh.
But I can come here thanks to you and all of your people. So anyways, so Zach has been on a lot of Broadway shows lately. My question...
Aren't you required to just sing song all the time?
What's that?
Aren't you required to just sing all the time?
Well, he got nominated.
I mean, it's not like a legal thing, but basically.
It's suggested.
It's suggested.
So my question for the rest of you guys is, if you had one Broadway dream role, what would it be?
Mm. Not everybody at once.
Sam fucking Winchester.
I know. Supernatural, the Broadway show. Would it be a musical?
Sure.
I'm just hoping that they bring this to stage, because I would love to play Flint Rider in Tangled.
You gotta work on your smolder, but okay.
True. By the way, every word I know.
Wait, do you really?
Hey,
I have a 3-year-old.
Easy.
I have a 3-year-old daughter. She wants to watch Punzel.
Is that what's coming up for me?
Yeah. Enjoy. Yeah. Can I watch Punzel?
God damn it. So you just hear my voice all the time.
You know what? Maria, I feel pretty.
How do you
You could totally do that.
Yeah.
We say, how do you solve a problem like Maria? It would be legit. We'd be like, how do we solve this problem of Maria over here?
Misha?
It's a different musical, but I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
I think I have to just piggyback on Jared here.
Oh, doing a supernatural? But okay, but
yeah.
They are having it out right now. I don't know what is going on.
Is that weird? Is that awkward?
They're debating Broadway.
Exactly. But hold on, but would Supernatural be, if it's on Broadway, is it a musical?
It's a musical.
It is a musical.
A lot of dancing, a lot of music, but definitely musical, obviously, I think. That's sort of a stupid question.
With the dancing and music, it'd be a musical, right?
And lots of sequins and feathers.
But Castiel?
Killing demons. Yeah. Killing them, we're killing them.
This is audition.
I'm just saying, we're workshopping right now. We're workshopping.
But it choreographs itself.
Early on.
Was that Dean or Sam?
Sure. Next question.
It choreographs right itself.
Right here. And kick, spin, turn, and.
So, first off, I have to say, because I will be very mad at myself if I don't, Jensen, you are so pretty.
And I have to sit next to him and hold it together.
You're so lucky. Anyway, so a few years ago, you came to, Mark, you came to...
Somebody's actually talking to you.
Pay attention! Yeah. It's so rare! Just me talking to them.
You chose the wrong time to laugh.
You came to my hometown, Sacramento, for Comic-Con Wizard World Comic-Con at Sacramento. Anyway, and I had shouted out, I love you, and you, like, walked down to me, and you're like, how do you know? And I just went blank and have been kicking myself for not having an opportunity to, like, say why. So, I'm taking my time. That's not really a question to say why, because I'm mad at myself for not saying it. Anyway, because I first started to watch...
If the alternative to hearing nice things about Mark is just you kicking yourself, I'd rather see you kick yourself.
No.
Fair
I'm
trade. Agreed.
Can you write him a letter?
I know.
Okay.
Illiterate. No.
Which is why she loves Mark.
I watched the first four episodes of Supernatural, was terrified, I decided I'm not going to watch this show. It's too scary for me because I'm scared of everything. And then my best friend told me Mark Sheppard's in it. I'm like, now I have to watch it.
That's what they said.
Hang on. And then, so then I started to watch it and got to the point where you're in it. It's like not scary anymore and fucking awesome. So thank you for being in it. That made me realize the awesomeness.
Look at him. Don't look at me. No. I gotta go over here somewhere. I got another pointer. Yeah, you, sir, with the long hair and the cap. Yes, right there.
First of all, Misha, thanks for the granola bars in the morning.
You're welcome. Yes. Thanks. It was really the Random Acts staff that you should thank. But thank Random Acts. Thank them.
Yeah. Thank Random Acts. And also, in these 11 years that you have been in Supernatural, like, what's your favorite phrase or line of your character?
Hey, ass butt.
Everyone.
What was that?
Hey, ass butt.
Jared? Jensen?
I gotta go with saving people, hunting things, the family business.
Mark?
Where's your moose?
I lost my shoe.
Can I add one?
Yes.
It's a toss-up between saving people, hunting things, and does this taco taste funny to you?
If I had a nickel. Right there. Yes.
You guys want some gummy bears?
Duh.
Oppie.
Just if you
throw them. Throw them.
No.
Throw them.
I don't know if she's athletic. I don't know. I don't need anybody getting a weird paper plastic cut on their head. Thank you very much. Thank you.
A paper or plastic cut?
Is that? No.
Are you a grocery bagger or something? Oh, one of those.
Yeah, one of those. And your question, darling.
So Jared. Have been telling us to always keep fighting, and you're proud of us, and you know we're enough. Everybody, what is something that you've done recently that you are proud of yourself for doing?
Misha? Thanks for making it weird, guys. Thanks.
I was, we were out at the park, and I managed to change my daughter's diaper without the shit rolling out of the diaper onto me. It was close. It almost hit me. It rolled off the dashboard, like right past me, but I moved just at the last minute. Jared?
The last nice thing that I did was not share a child feces story to the Nerdish community.
Jensen?
Jared, I appreciate that. I got nothing. Really, I'm just, you know, sad sack of regret.
No. We'll work on that. Yeah. Mark?
Proud of myself for
what?
Being
what did you just say?
Me. Existing as Mark Sheppard.
Waking up every
just
day.
Just being me.
It's tough being me.
Seeing myself in the mirror.
Why do you make me sound like a pirate and you make me sound like I'm in Monty Python?
HQ, yarr.
I'm super proud of it. Yeah. Yeah, I look in the mirror and I see a beautiful man.
The seas are stirring me today, mate. Shiver me timbers, I'm Mark Sheppard. I don't know what that is.
It's spot on, is
I mean,
what it is.
Mark?
You know what my favorite letter is?
What, Mark?
You think it's R, but it's the C.
Ah.
I didn't know that!
But you're me, and I'm you, and we are Mark. Yep. Yep. More smolder, more smolder. You need to be...
So Mark's answer is he's proud of what he just did right now.
He just turned into Marcel Marceau. He's doing mime now. We've scraped the absolute bottom.
I was trained. Oh, God, this is painful.
All the way in the back. Yeah. You're multiple...
doing an impression of Jared? I was...
Hi, guys.
That was B. Arthur, actually.
It was me. Called you B. Arthur.
No, I was doing an impersonation of B. Arthur.
I said, are you doing an impression of Jared? You said, no, I'm doing B. Arthur. So you...
Yeah. I'll take that. I'll take that quip.
Thank you.
I'll take that quip.
Yes.
Hi. Just wanted to congratulate you on season 12. Very exciting.
Thank you.
Thank you for all, you know, the past 11 years. It's been amazing. This question is for Jared and Jensen. What are your thoughts on Mama Winchester coming back?
Mama Winchester, I think it's awesome because on a serious note, like we've, with Sam and Dean really, Sam probably a little bit more, we've never seen Sam Winchester be a son. I know he had John, but he wasn't really like father-son with John. It wasn't like, hey dad, you know, it was more like, you know, F you, contentious, headbutting, a lot of anger and resentment. And so I'm excited to see Sam be somebody's son because he's kind of been a lone wolf. You know, as soon as he could leave the house, he left. He was like, all right, Dean, dad, do your thing. I'm going to college. I'm going to be a lawyer. But now we get to see him with his mom who he never knew and who he loves, but he doesn't know. So I'm really looking forward to exploring that.
It's obviously this is a you know, a unique situation, the fact that there's really not a relationship that the sons have with their mother, because when Dean was four, Sam was a baby. So the fact that she's back, and then, she, you know, from even from her standpoint, here are two grown men that are technically her children, but she has no relationship with. So she's not only going to have to kind of try to navigate this new world that she's just found herself in, which is modern technology, but it's also she's got to deal with the fact that both of her sons grew up to be exactly what she was trying to protect them from being, which is hunters and living in a hunter world. That being said, from Dean's perspective, I think that having her around is obviously super cool and interesting, but it also, I think it makes him vulnerable now because it's another thing in his life that people can use to, you know, it's somebody else that it's basically somebody else that he will sacrifice himself for. When before, really, all he had to worry about was his brother. Now he's, you know, now he's got his mom. So it's it opens itself up for a lot of different interesting situations, I think.
Does that answer your question? Fantastic. Guys, we have time for one, maybe two more, depending on how fast we go. And I'm going to go right there, right in the middle there.
I don't have a question. I just wanted to say, Jared, thank you for sharing your panel. Yeah. And especially... especially for those of us who couldn't go to the Comic-Con one.
All good. Thank you very much. Thanks, all right, Jamie. We're going to go right there.
This question is actually for Mark. Mark.
Is that a paper cut or a plastic cut?
You're a huge fan favorite.
Thank you.
Huge.
Just call me fat? Sorry, did you just call me fat? No, huge is in a lot of people. Oh, a lot of people
said
like you, yeah.
Fab.
Oh, okay.
Huge fan favorite. Everybody loves you. Your character is not... Your character is not heroic or even sometimes...
Yeah, that resonates. That resonates, yeah.
You didn't think this through before you stood up, did you?
It's not even sometimes likable.
Yeah. Are you confusing him and his character, or what's the...
Yeah, are we talking about Crowley or Mark?
No, so what do you attribute your huge... I mean, everybody really loves...
It is boggling that he would have any fans, isn't it? And thank you for that softball.
out of the park. I have to tell you that it's the love of my friends and the love of you guys, which none of this would be possible without any of you. It is the most fantastic experience of my life. Love you all. Top that, Levi.
One last question.
I'm gonna give it to you because you squeaked like a mouse. I didn't know that was possible. Sorry, you don't have any friends.
We can hear you. What's the question?
This is magical. No. Let her carry on. Because I'm
having. That's awesome. Go ahead, darling. Go ahead.
So there's tons of episodes in the past couple seasons, but I do have a favorite one. Mine is Heart, and I think it's because of the relationship between the two brothers, and you get to really see how, you know, it's the first season, and you really start to see the relationship between the brothers and how close they are and how much Jared is still trying to figure himself out
as
a character. Sam.
Jared has not figured himself out.
No, she's right. I am still trying to figure myself out.
Sam's trying to figure out where he fits in this hunter lifestyle, and he's not really ready for it. So Dean steps up to be able to say, I'll do it for you. So that episode is my favorite out of all of them, and I was wondering if you guys have a favorite episode and why.
I feel like you've probably been asked that question before.
Yeah. I have a few go-tos. I mean, for me, the one-offs, like the babies and the French mistakes and the changing channels and the real Ghostbusters. Yeah, those have a really cool special place, but I don't consider them a classic part of Supernatural. You know what I mean? Like, to me, I'm gonna separate all the one-offs. And I'm gonna go back to something I think Mark touched on earlier. I think my favorite episode, God, it might be either Swan Song or Sacrifice. Yeah. Yeah, two big episodes. Sacrifice is very personal to me. I at a time when I kind of needed it. So that's being selfish, but yeah.
Jensen?
I don't know. Again, there's out of, what, 241?
Who's counting? 242 now. We just finished episode one.
All right, who's counting?
I would have known.
Me, obviously.
Obviously.
I never got past the season five, so I don't really know what that's...
I didn't either, by the way. I haven't...
Yeah, he's been checked out for 7 years.
I know you were there.
There's a few. I really, like you said, I think Baby was one of my favorites for sure. But I also really, I often think about the end, and just what that was.
It just seemed like you were getting a lot of attention there. So,
Chuck, bless you. Chuck, bless you.
So I would go with the end.
Misha?
I remember, Jensen, you in the end. You were at the end of your rope. It was because Jensen in that episode was playing past or future.
Well said. Well said.
Thank you. Future Dean and present Dean, and he was having to play opposite himself in scenes, so he was literally...
He finally had to deal with himself, and it got the best of
him. It was awful.
You were like, I can never do this again. You were unraveling.
Which is why for the next five seasons, I'm the one who ended up playing every different variation of Sam. Because Jensen's like, nope.
Never again.
No likey.
Mark?
It's between two. It's between Abandon All Hope, when I set foot on a stage with these guys, and they just kept smiling at me and going, don't worry, it's going to be so much fun. And I think the end of season eight, which was just an experience that was just mind-blowing.
And I have one, yeah.
I was going to say, I would say, where's the camera?
They're up in the back.
Any episode directed by Robert Singer?
Good call.
And or written by his wife.
I want to say thanks to Zach and the whole Nerd HQ gang. Years and years strong and running. You made a place for a lot of us who, even though some of us are on TV and some of us aren't, a lot of us feel like outsiders a lot. And you made a home base for us to come and have good conversations and raise money for a great cause. And good on you. Good on all you guys who helped put this together.
So. Let's hear it for these guys. Give it up for these guys. Keep it going for these guys. Come on. Giving you love. Get out of here. Yeah, don't forget your bag of cash. Keep it going. Half-eaten bag of gummy bears, $240. Seriously, $20? No, you know what? Just take them. There you go. Where's those other ones? Here we go. I want some gummy worms. Oh, you know what? You get them. You went to have fun getting back to Australia, and you're welcome for the memories. Ladies and gentlemen, please have a seat. Actually, no, everybody get up. No, I'm kidding. This is it. It's okay.
Everybody, stay where you are, please. Why don't you have a seat? We're going to exit row by row.